Well, Malcolm Turnbull's son has acknowledged his role in orchestrating donations for at least one independent seeking to unseat a Liberal MP, as revealed by Nine News. It comes as the citizenship fiasco returns, threatening panic on the campaign trail, which brought some embarrassing moments in Sydney today.
Rolling up his sleeves, shaking hands and meeting voters.
Nice to see you. How are you doing?
Scott Morrison is campaigning in Sydney's multicultural inner west. Hoping the coalition has more luck keeping the marginal seat of Reid. The Prime Minister wouldn't bite over revelations by Nine News that Malcolm Turnbull's son Alex is helping the campaign of one-time Liberal MP turned independent, Julia Banks, to unseat Health Minister Greg Hunt. She's one of four independents benefiting from unusual and similar funding structures.
The questions about this Independence Inc. issue is really for the independents to answer.
But one of the targets hit back.
They probably should be upfront that they're not independent and that they're not grassroots.
Alex Turnbull confirmed his involvement in a series of tweets, starting with "Hell yeah," then rolling climate change deniers and racists and getting sensible people into Parliament, what's not to like, before deleting them.
That's it.
The opposition leader, Bill Shorten, was happy to milk it.
The Liberals didn't object to Turnbull money when it was going to them.
There's a sense of deja vu in the election campaign. Section 44 of the Constitution caused chaos in the 45th Parliament, and it's doing the same for some who wanted to be in the 46th. Three Liberal candidates in Victoria have been forced to withdraw over constitutional concerns.
They've identified the problem and they've fixed it, and I'm pleased they've done that before close of rolls, because that's what I expected them to do.
Bill Shorten can't promise there won't be accidents in his party.
I can guarantee that my party is doing everything it can to eliminate any constitutional doubt.
The opposition's lost one. Melissa Park pulled out of the race for the West Australian seat of Curtin because of her views on Israel and Palestine.
She has very strong views. I don't share those views. She's felt in the context of this election campaign that she would become a distraction.
Both leaders took a break from the election race to watch a horse race.
Whoa! I love it when a favourite wins.
Kerry Yaxley, Nine News.
Well, live now to political reporter Ailey Walsh on the campaign trail at Glenwood this evening. Ailey, where to next for the two leaders?
Well, Mark, I think it's interesting to note that the two leaders have spent the first two full days of campaigning in the Greater Sydney region tonight. Bill Shorten is in Glenwood, as you said, here at a religious festival, and this is in the Labor-held electorate of Greenway. Tomorrow, though, he's heading to Liberal land. He's heading back to the seat of Reid for the second time in just 3 days. As for Scott Morrison, well, right now he is in the air. He's keeping his cards close to his chest, Mark, and en route to a mystery location.
Ailey Walsh, live from Glenwood. Thank you.